When they say that a fighter makes a million, how much does the fighter actually walk home with? Because Bernard Hopkins once said that he made like crazy money and he walked home with $17,000.
Look, if you make a million, I'm just gonna give you a
on paper,
right? You know,
yeah,
$1 million. A fighter normally pays 30%. Manager, trainer.
Okay, so that's 700.
So that's 700. From that 700, you still got to pay taxes.
Which is half.
So no, it's not half.
40?
It's not half because there are a lot of write-offs.
Okay.
You know, boxers, you know, you're self-employed, so everything is a write-off. So you end up paying maybe from the seven, you end up paying maybe 150, 200.
So
you keep 500 for sure. So it's like half.
So like it's half. Not a million, you walk home with half, but still
yeah,
it's
like
a lot.
Half, 600, somewhere
so
around
if
there.
You get a million payday, it's not like you're going to have a million in your pocket.
No.
You're going to have 500.
That's what I said.
So yeah.
You keep 600. 500 to 600, buy yourself two small properties that are gonna give you $1,000 a month each, but in fucking 20 years, that rent's gonna be worth $3,000 each.
That's true. And plus, you'll only have a place to stay.
My house in Oxnard.
Yeah.
My house in Oxnard, I bought it for $250 in 2000.
And that was amazing. Back then, $250 was probably very expensive.
It was a new house, the new fucking development in Oxnard,
yeah,
whatever.
Yeah.
Everybody was crazy about those homes. And
you got a couple properties too
in Oxnard. I have my house in Oxnard, where I lived in Oxnard, and I never sold it. And that when I was living there, you know, if you ask around, the rent was probably going for $1,200.
Yeah.
You know, right now my house, I'm renting it for $3,300.
That's Beverly Hills prices.
$3,300 a month.
That's a lot
and
of
the
money.
The house is worth over $600.
And it's paid off already, pretty
the
much.
The house is worth over $600.
And if one day you're like, I want to sell it.
If I want to sell it,
yeah.
I sell it and I
half
give myself $600, well, what, taxes, whatever. I'll
yeah.
keep half a million, invest somewhere else. But why would I fucking sell
no,
it?
No, that's like retirement.
Why
no,
would I fucking sell it if it's giving me $3,300 a month?
Clean profit.
Every day, every month, $3,300. Why would I fucking sell it? You know what I mean?
Yeah, straight up.
And
I got a condo. I have a condo here in Moreno Valley. I bought it for $105.
That's nothing.
$105. It's a three-bedroom condo.
That's amazing.
$105. And I'm getting $1,300 every month.
Did you buy it brand new?
Yeah, no, it wasn't brand new, but it was $105,000.
That's nothing. That's really cheap. Today you can't
buy
anything like that.
My dad bought condos here. Two. He's got three now in that same area. But when he barely moved here, two condos where my sister, my two sisters, and my grandma have their places right there. He got two condos for like $50,000.
Wow.
One was $60,000 and the other one was $50,000, and he rents it out for like $1,300 each.
So he made the money
so,
back in no
you know
time
what I
plus
mean?
Profit.
So it's easy. That's
what you have
money.
To think about. I mean, I know it's fun to buy crazy jewelry and nice stuff, but
but you're young, you know. So you buy your okay. I'll tell you, what the fuck? Why are you doing that for? Because right now you're still not in a level, in a position where I know you're not spending all your money because you're not making a lot of money. But if I knew you were making $600,000 and buying $400,000 car, then I'd be telling you something.
I see a lot of it in every sport. A lot of athletes go broke, a lot of them in every sport, because they. One thing the NBA player told me that he lost $20 million. He goes, Elie, I thought I'll get another contract, and the next contract
and
never came.
It never comes.
And he never saved
it
his
never
money.
Comes.
He bought this way. He partied every weekend, and they spent like $50,000 on a party.
That next some fighters, that next fight is never gonna come.
No. So what do? You have to always think about the future.
Yeah. Something okay. Next fight. Fuck it. I got next fight. I'm gonna make $3 million. That fight might never happen. Might never happen.
So, and you also, should fighters open up another business to have another source of income?
It's hard. Business is hard. You know, like a lot of them think about a restaurant or something. It's hard.
You guys had a restaurant.
It's hard. Well,
it's hard
okay,
because employees,
hard.
Cleanliness,
you have to be there
the
24/7,
food.
24/7.
Yes. Electric. Yeah. He's getting educated. You know, you can't buy this kind of education.
Hey, but you know what? His mom works in the restaurant business and she knows a lot about
so
restaurants.
Maybe
so one day, maybe they could open up a restaurant.
What would you call your restaurant? Espinos?
Macizo.
Macizo.
Nah, I don't know, man.
Because his mom knows restaurant business.
But listen,
huh?
Vegas, a good place.
So,
have a sports bar.
Yeah, so, you know,
but don't be drinking.
Be successful with a restaurant.
Yeah, he can show the fights
what
there.
What I want to do is open up a barbershop with my brother.
A barbershop.
Because he cuts hair.
There you go.
And he's a barber.
Then
so.
Perfect. Then open up a barbershop for him. Y renta lugarcito. You know how that
works. Rent out
little
yeah.
spaces. Like, he's not the only one. You're going to have five or six, but you
yeah.
rent out, and then he makes his money.
Hopefully you get...
With the rent, he you pay off everything else.
Yeah,
so
hopefully
easy.
You become famous,
that's
so people
easy.
Will come because it's your place.
Yeah, that's perfect.
Yeah.
That's perfect.
But what about sponsorships, Robert? How come some fighters get majors? Is it politics?
Yeah,
is
but
it
there's
business?
Not, there's not a lot of money in sponsors either.
No.
It's like, okay, Frank.
Yeah.
Frank finds sponsors for these guys, for Mikey, for whatever.
Yeah.
Frank, you know, gets a $10,000 sponsor.
Okay.
For him, he hustles and he fucking fights for his percentage. Because for him, $2,000 is all he's gonna make. The fighter is gonna make $200,000, $150,000, $2 million, $3 million.
Yeah.
So it's more of a fucking. Yeah, or for cowboy boots.
For cowboy boots.
If you like cowboy boots, why not? They're expensive.
But you're like, I mean, so me personally, if I have Mikey,
yeah,
who has made millions, or
right,
in his fights, go, you know, he doesn't need to ruin his fucking Mikey sign right here. His Mikey, you know, because he likes to have Mikey.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
His Mikey, because somebody's gonna give him $20,000 to put their. It's a lot of money
for Frank. But if they gave Mikey $200,000 or $500,000, $1 million, that's talking.
Story, you know,
Alexis Espino, $20,000 is a lot because he's just starting his career.
Right.
He changed his last name right now.
Fuck.
He would say somebody else's name on the back.
But you know what I mean?
But in five,
so,
yeah, six
so,
fights.
So Mikey doesn't want to ruin his Mikey name right here for 20.
But for Frank,
40, 50, whatever. He does it, you know, he does it, but under or maybe someone else. You know, okay, that's fine. You know, Frank, it's a lot for Frank. You know what I mean?
Yeah. And then Frank thought that they got a sponsorship for $6,000.
I represent Mitsubishi because I was a good man.
Down on,
that's why I represent
them. Battery.
Oh, okay. Well, just... yeah, why not? All
right.
How many people you got live with you now?
And then Adidas too. 10. Don't forget, well, right?
206.
We got this shit.
We kept the audience.
Don't like
it. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
But Robert, you've been with Abbas from Mitsubishi.
Like
has been very loyal. And loyalty goes a long way.
He's very, very...
He's helped you out with cars, with the amateur team, with the van.
Always texting me and calling, you know, we're friends. That's what it is. We're friends. We just have a good friend relationship. He's been good to us all the time for many years.
Anthony Joshua says, Eddie Hearn said today in an interview that he wants a rematch in New York to rewrite history. Good idea, bad idea. Why not go back home where you did good?
No, because that's where he lost. Where he wants to know that he's got pride too. That's where he's. That's where he wants the fight to happen. I'm okay with it.
What if he doesn't? What if he goes through the same thing?
Then it was meant to be. It was just meant to be. He's done. He already made a lot of money. Also, fucking retire. Who gives a fuck?
That's true.
But I think he could do better. I think he could do better in the rematch. You know. I got Andy Ruiz because he's Mexican and I've known him from early in his career fighting for top rank. Manny, I've known him for many years. Great people. You know, I know what a trainer goes through. I've said it before many times, but I think Anthony Joshua with a good game plan could win the rematch. But he's got pride and he wants to do it in the same place where he lost. Oh, I don't blame him. I think it's a good idea. Fuck it. Let's do it.
You know what's crazy? I asked Miguel Cotto this week, what's his biggest win in his career? And I was very surprised at his answer.
What did he say? Rematch with Margarito?
Right.
That's what he said, right? For him, it wasn't that it was the biggest win. For him, it was more about that pride because he wanted that fucking win from the fight that he took a beating with Margarito, and then that controversy with the ref. But there's nothing he could say or do to prove that Margarito had loaded gloves. He can't. He believes so because he took a beating.
But Margarito hit hard regardless.
He took a beating against Pacquiao too.
Stopped.
So was Pacquiao also had something illegal in his hands?
And Saddam Ali beat him.
But that's late.
Okay.
You know.
Should have been Mikey in the ring that night.
Should have been Mikey.
Should have been Mikey in there against Cotto the last fight.
But look.
154 champ.
Should have don't count
anymore.
Yeah,
I know. That's true.
But Cotto took a beating by Margarito.
Yeah.
He cannot say that Margarito had something illegal in his raps because, as everybody knows, when there's championship fights and that big, you always have somebody from the opposite corner
observing.
You have the inspector also observing every fucking thing you do. So when he sent, I don't even know who from his team came to see Margarito's. Margarito's hand wraps, but I'm sure he was keeping an eye on everything, so he didn't see anything. He approved it. You have to approve when you leave. You have to approve it. Then you come back.
And there's a commission looking too.
There's a commission there too. So that means they didn't have anything.
Where was the first fight? Physically?
Vegas, I think. Yeah,
okay.
Vegas.
But But for him, that was his biggest.
But for him, because he still believes Margarito had was loaded. And
maybe he just can't accept the loss. Like some fighters,
maybe it's
always.
Possible. It's possible. You look.
Is Margarito still active, by the way?
No, he's still around. He comes once in a while.
No, is he fighting? No.
I don't think so. He hasn't fought in a while.
I'm sorry. What were you
but look, Cotto's a great fighter. Probably as a fighter, I think he's probably the most accomplished Puerto Rican in history. Maybe people might think training that was better. You're gonna, depending on who you ask,
yeah.
From what I hear, people do like Trinidad better than Cotto in Puerto Rico, from what I've heard.
Personality-wise, yeah.
Personality-wise. There's others, you know, like Wilfredo Gomez, who was a bad motherfucker. There's been Camacho, you know, there's been, a lot of great fighters. But maybe Cotto has been the most accomplished. I like Cotto. I like his fucking style. He fucking fought beautiful when he was at 140. He was a young, you know, body shot punch, you know, he was great. But he's got, you know, he still has in his mind that, no, I know Margarito was loaded. Fuck, then, you know, he's going to live like that the rest of his life. It's kind of sucks, too. Kind of sucks. So beating him, you know, getting that win was probably the best feeling for him. But, you know, we went through so much that fucking to even get the license that, you know.
I remember.
We had two doctors in our fucking corner every fucking round. They were just looking for any little thing to stop the fight. They stopped it.
10th round, right?
Ninth or tenth round.
Yeah.
When Marito still had his best rounds. Those were Marito's best rounds. Everybody knows Marito always, his last two,
yeah,
three rounds are his best rounds. And they took that away from Margarito. I'm not saying, you know, I don't know. Maybe things wouldn't have been, maybe it wouldn't have changed. Maybe Cotto would have kept dominating. I don't know. But they took Margarito's two best rounds. And
that was in New York.
It was in New York. And it wasn't like it was, like his eye was that bad. It was already bad going into the ring.
Yeah.
So he was already fighting. He was already, you know, picking up the pace. So
it's boxing.
Cotto won, and he feels, that's the way he feels about that win. Then, you know, what did I do? I congratulated him.